Module 20 Portrait in Charcoal Imagination. I will show you a technique in charcoal that I have developed over the years. The dust of dry charcoal can be used to create beautiful effects. Though charcoal is an extremely flexible and a supple medium, it also requires a lot of patience and practice. The techniques involved in the use of charcoal, for example, smudging and erasing, are calculated and well thought process. These are excelled over a long period of continuous work. I will take some charcoal dust and just rub it on paper. Apply some charcoal directly and smudge the lines. Then I will continue to lift charcoal dust from the stick and apply it on paper to develop the eye sockets and nose. Further building the mouth, beard and the contour of his face. You must know the basic form of the head by now, and with enough practice, it should be easy for you to remain within right proportions. You can use all your four fingers and thumb. Each one will give you a different stroke. The quality of line will be very different each time you apply the charcoal dust using a particular part of your hand at a certain angle. I will develop here by holding the charcoal stick horizontally and creating two broad strokes on either side of the face. I hold the pestle very softly to create very delicate strokes and smudge them to achieve soft edges. Using eraser in a charcoal drawing will primarily help define highlights. Since you have just black and white along with various shades of grey, whichever area you choose to pick charcoal from by the use of an eraser will leave that spot as a stark white highlight. I will smudge the highlights too, for them to merge with the middle tones, and thus the transition from dark shadows to highlights is smooth. Softening the edges of the hair by running a cloth softly over the sides. I will add a few dark strokes over the eyes using the tip of my little finger carrying charcoal. Observe carefully how I will remove the charcoal from here by using an eraser in wavy strokes to add details to hair. The portrait carries a divine expression to bring out this particular feature. I add a slight presence of shoulders through very subtle of and soft strokes. I will smudge the drawing with the cloth, softening certain strokes by using my fingers or the side of my hand. A portrait from imagination will always express your frame of mind, as the portrait begins to reveal its expression and mood. Consciously think of the elements to add in order to emphasize the vibe of the face. And adding depth by darkening the areas around the eyes. Nostrils and eyes. It could be anything, like in this case, I realized the adding a presence of cloth over his shoulders will bring out the divine character of the face further. Similarly, it could be a cap, beard, earrings, or other elements to support the mood of your drawing. Basic guidelines to put together any drawing through the use of dry mediums remain the same. The tools and the techniques are similar, except for the fact that when talking about charcoal, we are strictly talking about black and white drawings. Charcoal is not understood or perceived as a colorful medium. Thus, the rule of the game changes only at the point of applying colors. There, the study of tones and nature of warm and cool colors begin to come in use. The technique of smudging, mixing, or erasing by the use of fingers, a cone made out of paper, a cloth, cotton, and eraser are the same across all dry mediums. Since charcoal is a black and white medium, you need to be far more alert and change the gear of your observation to interpret a portrait. The light and shade, highlights, etc. are all expressed differently as compared to the use of color. I will sketch a few lines very quickly all over the paper. It is my years of practice that follows me to confidently move my charcoal stick. While I draw from imagination, I have a basic form in my mind. Yet my mind remains free and expresses the emotions in my subconscious. I do not struggle remembering the rules in order to not go wrong. To reach till here, you will have to practice every day. I am bringing out the ice. Nose and other facial features through direct application of charcoal from the stick, simultaneously smudging the strokes with my fingers for the final portrait to appear soft. The charcoal I am using has some lead mix. It is not pure soft dry charcoal. So you will notice that smudging these strokes is not very easy, since that is a character of my material. I will build a portrait accordingly. I will, instead of my hand, use cloth, applying some pressure to merge the charcoal. The color of the paper also is helping me to achieve depth. It is also acting as the skin tone for the portrait. I am smudging the areas around eyes, a lot around the beard and hair. Now I will pick the charcoal stick and darken the line. Where the lips meet. Look carefully how I use my finger to smudge the charcoal. Since this particular charcoal has oil content and is not a dry charcoal stick. It gives effects similar on an oil pastel, creating dark and dense areas. I am creating dark tones, as the middle tones are already present through the color of the paper. Even if I leave these highlights as it is, they will look beautiful, as they are middle tone highlights. They are not white or very sharp. I will use the eraser over the nose, lifting very little charcoal from the paper to create a soft highlight on the nose. As you can see that drawing a portrait in charcoal or any other dry medium requires us to use our fingers for smudging. Application of charcoal stick directly on paper and erasing the charcoal for highlights. It is yet very hard to say which of these steps to take in what quantity and in what order. These decisions are spontaneous. They require experience and practice of the medium. I am applying a grey dry pastel to tone down areas which are too dense and provide some relief around the eyes, nose, beard and the left side of the face where the light falls directly. Portraits done from imagination are the reflection of your subconscious, so allow your mind to flow. Do not think or plan anything when you begin. Keep your mind blank and do not have a plan about what you are about to draw. After you have the basic sketch, you can start thinking of rules and fundamentals to apply in order to bring out the best in your work. I will smudge the harsh lines with my little finger before I pick a charcoal stick and use it horizontally or flat over the portrait's hair rather than holding it like a pencil. I will work a little more on the beard, adding dark wavy strokes. You can continue to work on portraits done from imagination for as long as you like. Keep adding details or elements as they are all coming from imagination. Thank you. unlike a live model sitting in front of you. The portrait done from imagination is not a task that has a finish line. At darkest shadows on the upper eyelid, mouth, chin, at the end of his beard. I will smudge the shadows slightly to avoid forming harsh lines. Adding a dark shade of grey in dry pistils between the lips. The nature of this particular portrait is soft lines and softer edges, so I am avoiding harsh line completely. I will smudge the line with my finger. I will add a glint of light in the eye using white pistol. This is very important. As it brings the eyes to life and makes the portrait appear more alive. Add the white dot carefully. And smudge the corner of the eye to add softness. Add a good fixative to your work to not let your work smudge. That is a very crucial step to preserve your work longer. Thank you.